The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Many of the Jews who had come to Mary and seen what Jesus had done began to believe in him. But some of them went to the Pharisees and told them what Jesus had done. So the chief priests and the Pharisees convened the Sanhedrin and said, "What are we going to do? This man is performing many signs. If we leave him alone, all will believe in him, and the Romans will come and take away both our land and our nation." But one of them, Caiaphas, who was high priest that year, said to them, "You know nothing, nor do you consider that it's better for you that one man should die instead of the people, so that the whole nation may not perish." He did not say this on his own, but since he was high priest for that year, he prophesied that Jesus was going to die for the nation, and not only for the nation, but also to gather into one the dispersed children of God. So from that day on, they planned to kill him. So Jesus no longer walked about in public among the Jews, but he left for the region near the desert, to a town called Ephraim, and there he remained with his disciples. Now the Passover of the Jews was near, and many went up from the country to Jerusalem before Passover to purify themselves. They looked for Jesus and said to one another, as they were in the temple area, "What do you think, that he will not come to the feast?" The Gospel of the Lord. Jesus Christ. Praise be Jesus and Mary. But one of them, Caiaphas, who was high priest that year, said to them, "You know nothing, nor do you consider that it is better for you that one man should die instead of the people, so that the whole nation may not perish." You know po, mga kapanalig, this part of the gospel predict what will happen to our Lord and the desire of the Pharisees and Sanhedrin to really kill our Lord. And the same Caiaphas, we will remember, will be the one who will persecute our Lord, and will be the key figure for the passion of our Lord Jesus Christ. And yet, on the background, Jesus is really, the God the Father is doing the will, God's will. Although, yun nga po, medyo mahirap, and yet, that will be accomplished. But I think it is also good to ask if what Caiaphas said is valid all the time. And this will be our reflection for today. Valid ba? Parati? Or we can say that it's a valid reasoning yung sinabi ni Caiaphas na mas mabuti pang isang tao ang mamatay kesa ang buong nasyon. Sacrifice one person for the nation, or sacrifice one person for many people. In the case of Jesus, of course, but some moral theologians said that it is not that often. Just to give an example, no? Halimbawa, ang isang babae na nabuntis, no? Pwede bang sabihin ng isang babae, para sa ikabubuti ng aking pamilya, lalo na kung mayaman yung babae, o para sa ikabubuti ng boyfriend ko, ipapapatay ko na lang, ipapa-abort ko na lang itong bata sa aking sinapupunan. Pwede po ba yun? For the sake of many, you will kill a person. Or sabihin na natin, patayin natin yung isang importanteng sa bansa, no? Para lang, no, mapagbigyan yung ibang ano, nakararami. That is not always the case, no? Sabi nga, importante tignan, no, pa rin, no, especially if it is a bad action or bad act, to look not only to the benefit of the majority. Yun. Kasi parang lalong-lalo na ngayon, mag-i-election. They think, anyway, no? Para sa ikabubuti naman ang gabos ng lahat, sige na. But that is not always the good reason to do such a thing. So, our gospel today wants us to reflect. Are we doing the same thing just like the Pharisees and Caiaphas? Of course, not regarding our Lord, but in our daily community. Sacrificing our love for one person for the benefit of all. Of course, that is true. And yet, sabi nga, we should always look, sabi nga, sa moral, we have to look for the intention, the circumstances, and the action itself. Yun yung tatlo. Para maging good act, maging maganda yung kalalabasan ng ating mga gigibuhon o gagawin, titingnan natin ano ba yung intention. Pangalawa, yung circumstances. Pangatlo, no, ay yung mismong paggawa. Parang katulad nga na nanakawan ko si ganito for the sake na makatulong ako sa iba. No. You cannot make a good act good just because something good will benefit from that act. Hindi mo pwedeng gawin ang isang bagay na masama para sa ikabubuti ng gabos. That is not always the case. So let us ask our Blessed Mother, Mary Corredemptrix, Our Lady of Peña Francia, Divino Rostro, to help us to really discern in everything that we do. Huwag lang tayong gawa ng gawa. Huwag lang tayong ngawa ng ngawa. Let us always reflect, pag-isipan. And this is a challenge for our community today. Gabos sa atin po lahat. Because of the social media, it takes away our capability, our ableness to discern and to reflect. Praise be Jesus. And Mary. Ave Maria. If you like this video, subscribe and share. Ave Maria.